Hey, guys and girls. So I didn't mean to actually end that part off where I did, but we're battling Big Turtle Man. We took down all his group, all but these three here. So it's Turtle Man, Gangbanger, and Magic Thug. I think this one might be Loggins. I don't really know, though. But, yeah. Let's go for Turtle Man. Actually, we could just... I think we might just... No, let's go for Turtle Man. He's got too much HP not to hit. Gotta break him down. Ow. That didn't hurt as much as I thought, but still. Can I hit him? I can hit him with this. Do that. Fire Flame Attack. Get some type of hit in. I don't want you really getting hit by Turtle Guy. So, actually, move. Oh, what the hell? Can't move him. Alright, summon Heat Breath. You. No, because I feel like I'd be setting up them for a hit. Bomb Cannon. Yeah, I'm at 258. Digging it. Digging it, raking him down, little by little. Let's hope we can survive his hit, though. Because he's going to do some big damage, probably. Oh, yes, nice. Dodged. Not doing damage to him. Better do something more if you want to take us out. Because next turn, we're going to be doing some big hits to the turtle. Because... Oh, never mind. Well, we are going to do a lot of hits to him at the very least. Like that. Big hit. Big crit, too. That 84. Blade Slash.
Gug.
Ow. Don't worry. You will be healed. Appropriately. With a Kika Fruit. Take that. Let's drop a Grand... Grand Crash, I mean. Alright, and you know what? Bringing you in with your weapon. Slap him! Ow. Damn, he crit him? That's terrible. Damn, he's only got 18 left. That's terrible. Please survive the next turn. Okay, good. Please, back hitter, guys. Don't hit the kid. Yes, alright. Good. Good. You guys are awesome. I win. Oh, whoa, wait, hey, wait up, I say. You'll surrender if you know what's good for you. Now you know I can't do that. Oh my, aren't you a troublesome lot? Perhaps we should borrow the power of the legendary magical sword here, eh? He switched weapons? What is that sword? It doesn't feel normal. The legend thing might be a tall tale, but I'm in the business of trying my luck. Honestly, there are so many things about this sword I'm skeptical of. And it's a shame these are only summoners to try it out on, eh? Huh? What the? Was Stalius broke up? How is that even possible? What? That was with Stalius, and he broke it? No. Just no. That cannot be the real thing. It's gotta be some mistake. And today a worthless legend is destroyed before our eyes. Looks like everything we've invested for this has gone down the drain. Whoa, what the? Where did the attack come from? Oh man, what's going on?
Oh man, why did this happen? This way, quickly.
You, why did you come here? Actually, never mind, you saved me. Doesn't matter.
Logan, it's time to go. Let's get out of here. What are you talking about? We need to wipe the floor with these ones first.
Loggins, we're going. That is not up for negotiation. Don't make me repeat myself. No.
Hey, stop right there.
Don't chase them, Morelli. Let's just be glad we drove them away.
But I don't want to let them get away. After all they did here, we're just gonna let them go?
Take that frustration and channel that into fixing up the damage. How many students were injured?
Not many, fortunately. The injuries seemed to be light as well.
It's good that the injuries were light, despite the surprise attack.
Did you hear what the turtle guy said about the sword? I'm pretty sure he said the sword that broke was Vestalius.
You know, that name really rings a bell.
Can't believe that was the truth. It had to be a mistake.
There's no way something that legendary and magical would be here. And even if it was, there's no way it could be stolen so easily, right?
You're talking sense to me, Callus. Really, Senior, is everyone okay? Noe, are you okay?
Putting aside this business with the sword, I'm a little concerned about why that black suit was acting weird.
My oh my, this whole operation has been one big disappointment. After all that preparation, fighting, and manpower, we're still empty-handed. Not much I can think of more lousy than that. Summoners aside, I hadn't foreseen the steadfastness of the students.
I could have taken them all if you let me.
Loggins, are you still at it?
Yeah, man, I can't believe you made me leave before I won. The power I have now is hella bigger than anything the summoners have. There was no need to avoid a fight, because we would have won. But I'm stuck here trying to explain it to you now.
You're rambling like a crazy person. Do you hear yourself? You're listening to me. Are your ears in working order, bro?
You know it ain't right. I'm gonna go take those fellas down. That's right. By myself if I have to. We gotta teach the U-Cross and its summoners their place in our world.
Oi. He ran off. Just what the hell is going on? It's like the kids became an entirely different person. Talking back is one thing, but I can't let disobeying orders slide. After I get to the bottom of what's going on, I'll pick a punishment. I need you to get him back here. Now.
Yes, sir.
The tip of my nose is dry and ticklish. I don't like what that means. Something's up. That's a little weird that his nose is ticklish and he likes to say that, but okay.
Let's go talk to Torky.
This wasn't supposed to happen. I only wanted to claim my master's hammer. Torque, what's wrong?
Hello, Torque.
Huh? Teach, what are you doing here?
Well, maybe we should save the conversation for later.
Okay, sure thing.
Great principal, are you alright?
What? The fishing lady's the great principal?
Sis? I kept hearing one scary report after another. You're not injured or anything, I hope.
Celestia?
On the contrary, the battle had concluded by the time I arrived.
Great principal.
Foth, what are you doing here?
Why, because of yesterday's...
Bonelli, calm down, sis. Really, why are you here too? Might be better if I answered that after she calmed down.
Probably a good idea.
I'm sorry, my sis is a little high-strung.
I wonder what's happened, what's been bothering Twerk. He's obviously upset. All of this is my fault. I'm to blame. And it's all because I had to have the powerful master, my master's powerful hammer. When I was told I couldn't have it, I just...
About that. That was actually me. I gave instructions to clearly assess candidates. But I know I'm definitely worthy of that hammer. And unfortunately, that belief led me to consider stealing it. And those criminals saw an opportunity to take advantage of my need for it.
That's not... Turns out I have no right to wield the hammer. None. No, I don't even have the right to hone weapons, so I won't.
Hold on a sec, you're getting carried away again. Besides, you're the only one we can rely on to fix up our weapons. And you promised that one day when you create a great weapon, I'll be the first one you're going to give it to. Gotta keep that promise. But I just... I'm banking that promise more than ever now. You're not even hearing what I have to say. I don't have the right to wield the Master's Hammer for anyone anymore. Wait, Torque. Let me just ask you two questions. Why did you first want to forge the great weapon? I don't really remember. Probably something stupid like wanting to prove my excellence. Alright, what about now? Now? I already said I'm not going to. This is not difficult, Torque. Just forget all that and answer. What would my motive be to making that weapon now? Oh, me? Why are both of you staring at each other like that? I guess I found someone who needs that weapon. Someone who talks big but doesn't do a lot by themselves. A good person who relies on others, maybe a little too much. Before I even realized it, that person has come to rely on me as well. So I thought I might as well make a weapon that can be of use to them, I guess. Yes, I got it. I think that was supposed to be complimentary, but... Senior, those weren't really compliments. Celestia, can you bring the box in question? I knew it. I thought you might be ready, so I already have it in hand. Wow. Gotta hand it to you, Celestia. You read my mind. I think I'm just way too used to your whimsical requests for my own good. Yeah, that's not intentional, I promise. So, Torque, your master entrusted this to me. A letter? Bit late, isn't it? Just slow down and read that. Alright, here goes.
Dear foolish apprentice, you have genuine skills, and by technique alone, you've surpassed me. But there is one important thing you lack, and I failed to teach it to you in the workshop. No matter how good the steel, no matter how good the hammer, a blacksmith lacking this cannot forge the ultimate weapon. I'm leaving this letter with the person I trust the most. When the time comes and you have realized what you lack, I have asked that everything you need be handed over to you. So if you're reading this letter, it means that you know the answer. So accept my congratulations. You're now a full-fledged blacksmith.
That stupid master. This has to be another joke of his. Nobody teaches their apprentice like this. No one. Worrying, suffering, going the wrong way, getting corrected by another. What you find through all that is proof of who you are. Please, just open the box now. Very funny. So you give me an old crappy hammer as a joke. You're looking at the cheap hammer your master cherished most. Master was able to make a great weapon because he had this hammer. So you go and get... like this as well. Is that what you're getting at? Man, do I feel dumb. Stupid. Can you make what you would call a great weapon? I don't know. I just don't know anymore. But I'll try. Since I at least have a clear idea what I should be aiming for. That is the answer to the question you didn't even know. Nice work, Twerk. I'm happy for you, for the guy. Celestia. What's happening here? There's something that concerns me about what you said just now. It's getting late. Maybe we can have the conversation another day. It's only noon. Teach, if you don't mind. That's true. I should reintroduce myself. My name is Addie, and I'm actually the great principal of this fine academy. Well, great principal? The elusive great principal, one of the seven mysteries of the academy? I'm honored to meet you. Can you really cause someone to succeed in love?
This is like a unicorn sighting. You didn't ride in on one, did you?
I've heard about the rumors, but watching your reaction is priceless. Why are you telling them? This is far beyond the usual protocol. We can't just send them back without telling them anything. I'm thinking it's probably better to trust them and tell them everything. But your existence itself is top secret. And it's the most classified of all files on the Association of Packs.
Classified top secret.
The Civilier you cross finding out about you is a big problem.
Oh? An intriguing proposition.
That's why, you see, well, she's so flustered, I'm feeling a little sorry for her. Giving me special treatment just makes me uncomfortable. My only advantage is a long life and knowing about this academy forever. It's the basic reason I have become like a consultant for everyone. Don't downplay it. You're a legendary class important figure.
I'm not really seeing where this is going.
In the course of my long life, I've been called many things. Most notable of which was Bakensha, or Saver.
You're the Saver?
Saver? Huh? So let me get this straight. The same Saver from those legends we discussed. Bah! But the Saver was around during the World War... Warp War. Are you the one who wields the magical sword Infinite Blue with Stalius? Ah, your reaction is adorable, but it's making me blush. They have every right to be in awe. You're legendary. Well, this is where my sister's worked herself into tizzy. But please, none of you must breathe a word of this. The Saver's identity is the most treasured secret of the Association of Facts. If the public finds out about this, it will make things quite inconvenient.
You believe a force that is too powerful will spark conflict simply by existing.
You're quick on the uptake. And we've noticed that you downplay your importance. It's not unusual, and I'm embarrassed to admit this, but the Saver often refuses cooperation with the Association of Pacts.
Ah, I think I understand how you feel. Why are you saying that looking at me? Because, you know, you're kinda like that too.
Am I? This idiot isn't even aware of it.
The more immature a person, the less they are able to see themselves.
Sorry, Senior, but I'm afraid I have to agree with everyone. Nobody's on my side.
You said it would be inconvenient for the public to know about this, right? Which would include even the Silvaler brass. The Oka Division head should already know. Therefore, you have no need to hide this in your report. However,
that doesn't apply to my side, right? Don't worry, I get it. I'll just make something up and gloss this over.
I really appreciate it. I'm a little dumbfounded by this revelation. To be living in proximity to a legend and not even know it. The past and the present may seem separate and distinct at first, but somewhere somehow they are always connected. A great example is Tree Avenue. That place with the huge tree? Correct. That tree has watched over this academy for a long time. It's a surviving witness to history, just like myself. I know that trees live a really long time, but you're not talking about a tree with just a long life, are you? Please keep what I'm about to say a secret. I'm imploring you. Tree Avenue.
Excuse me. Sorry for the interruption.
Ah! Huh? You're from the student council. Is something wrong?
It's those guys. They're still wreaking havoc. They're in the tunnels under the school.
What?
Demon Crimson Chain? We'll have to talk more later. Let's go, everyone.
Okay. Whenever there's a battle, it gets me thinking. I can't protect what I want to protect with my own hands. And this is another case like that. My hands are tied. And it is really quite painful. Great principal. Oh, for goodness sake. Why are you always trying to carry the world's problems on your shoulders? Have a bit more faith in the world and the city that you have protected. You're not the only person who fights to keep a smile on innocent faces, right? I guess you're right.
Huh.
There, I found them.
Wait, something isn't right here. Oh, it's probably Loggins, right?
Black suits are littered all over the floor.
Not all of them. One is still bouncing off the walls.
Whoa, what the hell happened to him?
Something isn't right about that black suit. Yeesh, a normal human doesn't look like that. Something's wrong.
I will be stronger than anyone.
Duh!
It almost doesn't seem like he's human. I've got a bad feeling about this one. Be careful, everyone.
Summoners, come out to play. Summoners, come out to play.
Summoners, come out to play! Summoners, come out to play!
Everybody packed? Wait, hold up. I'm telling you, it is not easy to have things go as planned around here. I honestly thought we had more time before he lost his sense of self completely. So this means the end of doing those experiments in secret. Keeping them from the prying eyes of Atosh and Maddow. Gift, why are you here? Yeah, Foth, I'm sure it's really, really confusing. So rather than explain, I'll just give you something simple to digest. This is something like retrieving a lab rat that escaped a dangerous rat. Lab rat? Get this, the moment he showed up, that black suit went all docile, like a pet. You've stumbled into the next phase of my research. The phase where I finally manifest control of nether summon arts. Oh, Gift. Don't tell me you used that man to... You've got to know that what you're researching isn't summon arts. But to be precise, it is a branch of summon art. Long ago, summon arts caught otherworld beasts and enslaved them. But during the World War, that technique was lost. The beasts couldn't be called at will, and coercive power over them was lost, leaving only the odious burden you now call summon arts. No, life resident summon arts is a wonderful ability that... Which is why I have slaved to uncover the knowledge to return it to its perfect form. To rediscover the lost ability to repaint the very color of one's soul, using nether scooped up from the rift between worlds. But... Is this real life? You should recognize the black slime the beasts I use are immersed in. That nether contaminates the souls it touches, dyeing them black as the abyss. Then, nether has many other useful characteristics, too. Here, let me demonstrate. The fallen black suits are getting up. Looks like your friend's been busy making these nightmares. And it's about to get rough right about now. You should probably split to our... No, I want to fight. Well, now. I won't be a burden to you, promise. Alright, I'm gonna hold you to that. Are you sure you're not being too rash with the boy? We don't have time to debate this. Torque, if things start getting too dangerous, step back. Got it? Yeah, got it.
Oh, wow.
Damn, man. See, this is why I wish we got the rest of the Summer Night games. Because apparently, Addie, or the super principal, she is the female character you can pick in Summer Night 3. So she's lived. So that's Summer Night 3, I guess, is when the Warp War happened. And... You know, Summon Night 3 is a Summon Night we didn't get, sadly. Which came up for PlayStation 2 and the portable. It frickin' looks awesome, and I hate it that we wouldn't get this. That's pretty cool, though. So she somehow is like immortal or something. She's lived through all these crazy times. Summon Night became really turn-based. Summon Night 3 is when it turned like turn-based. Summon Night 2 and 1 had a more Tales battle system, I want to say. Like, they were really like Tales of Phantasia,
similar to that. And I don't know, I really liked them. They were cool. And not that I don't like, you know, the type of battles. I'm just saying. Alright, I'm talking too much. Let's get into this. What level are these? 15. They're not that powerful. Damn it, stop hitting her. Really? Guys? Gotta do with this range business on us now? Can I only move one over? That's weird. I removed everyone? Yeah. I actually should have healed her on that turn. I'm gonna hope that we can survive hits at least once more.
これで。
probably use this. Yeah. There you go. All right. Fine. When I hit her, she's guarding. Got her on the guardest of guards. Spinel being an arrow user, she counters don't work. Gotta guard it as much as I can. You can kill him. Oh, look who joined the fun. Wow. So does it mean he's gonna summon them now or something? No. Or maybe? I don't know. Gift is psycho. Not that much. Let's try and clear the field as best we can. Curious if he's gonna summon them, because if he is, yeah, he is. But he seems to summon them near him, so we could probably still kill and work our way back toward him. I took the crappiest route, though. Consider, because he's right down there, and I took the long route around. Super stupid of me. Bastard with that. We gotta get down there though. We gotta stop Gift or this will be never ending. Taking the crit damage. Bye. Oh, really?
Whatever with that.
Come on, guys! He's guarding!
The gift is protected by a wall of those psychos.
Three lined up in a row right there.
Gotta get rid of them. You take Kika. Move you to the right. Summon the Grand Crash. Hit those three. Move him in. Skill-wise. So, hit the back one. I think we won't kill this round, because I have to do this right, and if I kill, and they just bring more to fill up the slots, it's kind of heavy, but, everybody's defending.
Alright. I want to get across this bridge by next round. I want to get across it fully. Oh, of course you're gonna run back. You bastards. And I'm gonna put a fresh one right in the middle. Ow! They outthought me, damn it. They're not putting it on in the middle, which is kind of stupid of them, but okay. Kill that. Kill him. Watch up, big brother. Behind. Throw him at... Oh, wrong person. No, I screwed that up. Damn it. Give the Kika to yourself. I guess that's all we can do. I screwed it up. Gave the Kika to the wrong person. There's another one. Blocking the path. They're not strong. They're just kind of annoying. They
just appear every 5 seconds. Well, every turn. And they're really trying to take him out. Damn, even gifts? Oh.
A tickled. Stop tickling him. Guys, stop tickling him. He doesn't want to be tickled. Guys. It's not working. Now I can do this. Kika. Move back. Move forward. Now, it's life resonance. Aw, damn it, we're not gonna be able to shoot one in gift. That's why a life resonance. Damn it. I wasn't thinking. Damn it, man. That was supposed to be for him. Guys, come on. Need a faster skipping system for these soldiers. Another one. I know he's running and hitting us. Nothing. Come on. Ow. Bam.
Damn, 37 from that one? Is that one the original logins? It might be. He took 37. Pika for you. Get back. Crash. And damn it, he can't really move. I was hoping to get something else in. Heat breath or something. Looks like Gift survives another turn. Look at this army of crazies that he has surrounding him. Come on. Let us go. I'm ready. You're not gonna weaken us enough. Player turn. And you. There you go. Should be the end of that. Oh, or not? Okay. I guess we gotta beat the main one, maybe. Or we actually have to beat all these ones. The fact that it only took 30 something. Oh no, he's anti-magic, that's why. Okay. Damn, so we're just really left with cleaning up the rest of these garbage bastards. Actually should have healed someone because I know they did a load of hits on it. Probably. Callus. Thank you very much for lining up for me. That was a wonderful thing to do. Give you a Kika. Jinx it. Try and bring him in. He's hurt. He's weak. You are. Slice you. Shoot this one.
No, actually, let's find one with 70 HP. Yeah, yeah. No, you know what? Because back attack might take enough to kill. Oh, damn it. I didn't consider he was guarding. And everyone moved. Yep, we're good. Right. Really, guys? They're just like, everyone kill Torque at least. Ow. Well, first off, Torque is gonna get out of there because Torque is just being a liability right now. And second, moving you back, I'm gonna slice this guy. You're gonna shoot him in the face. And you are gonna use another Grand Crash on these three. And then you can kill this anti-magic one back here. Nope, that was the real one. Okay. Cool.
Alright, the freak army is down. Time to take down the puppet master. Don't rush things. There's still more show for you to enjoy. What the hell? The black suit. They just melted. My technique to control Nether has yet to be perfected. Once too much damage is absorbed, they disintegrate like this. I mobilized them in my panic, so I couldn't lose, but that backfired here. Gift. Do you understand what you're saying? They were all human beings. It is true that they were human at one point, but not anymore. Now they're nothing more than ugly black stains. Unholy smokes, this guy is rotten to the core. It's not like I don't regret what's happened to them, I do. But in advancing my research, mistakes will be made. Don't worry, next time I will have properly completed Nether Warriors. I will admit my loss today, but failure will not be a recurring theme. At least this time I didn't lose them all. I have some to bring back with me. Come, we're heading back. Follow me. Gah.
They're getting away. We can't let them get away. Capture them. No can do. That's all I can manage for today.
Yeah, we're all pretty beat up from that back-to-back fight. We're in no position to keep pursuing them.
Not again. It will be difficult to capture them. That one simply through a battle. There may be a need to set up a trap or concoct a special strategy. Gift, why are you doing this?
Big brother.
Yo, tough day, eh? Abert, don't take it too hard. It's gonna take some planning to take him out. You're not gonna help anyone by moping around being all sad and downcast. Just keep your head up until we get through this, okay?
Abert, you make it sound so easy.
But because you're the one asking, I'll do my best.
A long time ago, during the era of myths, the king of Elgo, bound by connections to the Linker, isolated the worlds one from another. The Summonite Stone became the only link to connect the worlds far removed. Summonarts were a powerful force, and Summonite a symbol of that strength. As a result, people sought them out, scrambling to attain them in any manner, in order to harness their power, to fulfill their individual desires. Some used summon arts to protect themselves, others to fulfill their dreams. Some found a place of their own in someone they wanted to protect. But as they say, all good things must come to an end, right? The coming of the Astrays brought the end of the pledges, and now Summonites are reduced to gems with a tiny... Strong summon arts were lost and the power of humanity reduced. Our legends are of ancient heroes who rejected a connected world. who fought using countless enslaved summoned beasts, but a hero like that can never rise from the world we have right now. Do you not find that unsettling? Do you not find that unforgivable? If an otherworld demon lord were to again attack, what would become of this world? A toothless world like this would have no way of resisting such an attack. Somebody has to do something to right this wrong, to patch our vulnerability. That responsibility waits for somebody who is genuinely concerned for our world.
Sir, preparations are complete.
I see. Well then, time to transition from plan to action. Now then, first and foremost, we need to thank the Crimson Chain for the help they've given us so far. Everything existing had a past and will have a future. Though we take the life we're living at present for granted, this life is actually something like a crystal, hardened by the pressure of the accumulated past of many people, the legendary Saver and Nether Summon Arts. Even if forgotten by the people, the past never goes away. Its imprint, its echo, is everywhere in the present around us. And I'm sure we will encounter more echoes of the past again soon. Somehow, somewhere, soon, it's a feeling I cannot shake. What's wrong, Yinghua? You look really depressed. It's funny and a little sad that you would be worried about me. Do I really look that pathetic? Well, sorta. You need to have some more concern for yourself before showing concern for others. In fact, you're the one who looks like death. Yeah, it's just whenever I think of Gift Brethren. Yeah, you did know about him then. I guess it's pointless hiding it now. However, let me guess, top secret? It's written all over your face that you're suffering. Because you can't tell me everything now. Not exactly. And I'm not as simple to read it as that. Why would I lie? You are easy to read. You are the first person to say that ever. Well, you have some liars on your force, or no one cares. You have to be some kind of weird special case, then yes, that's it. No, Yinghua, I don't think that's it. I understand you. That's the real thing of it. Chapter 9. Secret Hideout.
Warp.
God damn it.
We can't hold him back no more. Let's get out of here.
Unbelievable.
The hell's going on here? Gift was supposed to be our brother.
Perhaps our understanding of his status was misguided. I believe this is what is referred to as a double-cross brothers. That bastard was planning this right from the start. He's played his cards well. That cannot be denied. If he didn't leave us in this jam, I might have sent him congratulations.
Excella hates him. Velos despises him.
Can you two shut up? We already know. How many survived?
About 20, but they were swallowed by that freaky mud thing.
Yeah, but what happened next?
They were all dead-like, but suddenly they stood up again all at once. When they didn't come back, they were being like puppets on the other side.
So half our forces once in one fell swoop. A classic example of a crushing defeat. Where are you going? We won't be able to do anything with just the ones we have here. Crimson Chain has always been a collection of criminal organizations. I'll just go borrow some soldiers from the others that owe us favors.
Favors? You don't mean from the Lakebed City.
Desperate times call for desperate measures. I didn't ever want to see that face again either, but...
You better come right back. No side trips.
I finally started liking the taste of the city's cigars lately. I'll be back before I run out, brother.
Price of aspiration. Cruelty of real.
Thoth! Thoth! Wake up!
Yinghua.
You're finally awake. It's quite late now.
Feels like I only slept 10 minutes.
I understand the feeling. A lot has happened and it takes a toll. But this is not the time to surrender to its psyche. Psych yourself up and let's go.
I have no idea where she gets that drive. Sorry you have to look up to her drive instead of mine. Oh, no, 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 that's not what I meant. You mean to say I'm too straight-laced, right? I know, and I'm aware. However, it is a required part of my duty. There's a necessity for it. You don't have to explain to me. I'll keep relying on your help in the future. Relying on me? Sounds like the kind of thing you'd say, all right. So what shall we do today? Let me see. There's someone I want to talk to. Once we've finished our other businesses, let's go to the academy. All right.
I actually want to see how much we've leveled before we do that. So we for sure leveled. We got 2 levels on both. So I probably got 2 on everyone I've used in the battle, most likely. 22 for Yanghua. Axel turn. 21. Got 1 level. That's about all we got. Yeah.
So the great principal is run off somewhere.
Addie. Yeah, so this is apparently what, like, because each Summon Knight game, you can be a female or male. This is apparently supposed to be the female version of the Summon Knight 3 hero. Ah, she's fishing. See, they brought back memories, and I'm sad because I feel like I would have been like, because she's talking about this and that, but I don't remember. I never played it. The Colorless Faction.
A being with a soul were possessed by it. Fragments of documents recovered.
Nether.
Damn. So we know the guys have gifts planned. Another beast? Oh no. He's starting his attack already. Alright, where's it at? Is it on the outskirts? It is.
Faulty.
Wait, that's... Yes, Blue Machine Summoner. He's fighting Nether Beast now?
Raid pattern, green.
Gift isn't here. What's going on? Where did the beast come from if he's not here? Did you summon them, Blue Machine Summoner?
I didn't.
I find that hard to believe. Who else could have done it then?
You know the answer as well as I. Gift Bratern holds that power alone.
Then he must be somewhere nearby, summoning from a distance, right?
An incorrect assertion. Nether is neither something that belongs to this world, nor something that adheres to the laws of this world. No matter how badly you injure, crush, or pulverize it, it never disappears. A beast of this size would regenerate to its original form within a few days.
Regenerate? Then the beast just now... So they were the revived forms of the ones we defeated before?
You understand, so be gone. This is a fight beyond what you can deal with. Slashing, stabbing, beating, no matter what method you use, the essential truth of Nether will prevail and come again.
You talk as if you're the only one who could possibly do something about this. Why is it that we will fail, but you have the secret of success?
Your ignorance will be your undoing. Behold.
What are you? He's absorbing the Nether into his arm.
The Nether that Gift has summoned must be absorbed to be stopped. Now do you believe me that you should not be here? Don't concern yourself with us. Don't touch us, or you'll be in danger.
I can't even believe what I'm... I knew it. You're quite attached to Foth, aren't you? Blue Machine Summoner, or should I say... Erst Brattern! What?
That's a name I've not heard for a long, long time.
It can't be. Are you really Erst?
Your special knight from the Sylvalair knows more than she reveals. She knows some of what's happening, but her mission is misguided.
You don't say.
Right now, we are no longer Erst. That person no longer exists. We have touched the Nether. Nether erodes the soul and causes it to cease being one of a person. The Erst that you knew has been swallowed by the black voice of the Nether, along with his cross, Gaudi.
So they're formed into one. With his cross?
What you see before you is the end result of a contaminated soul. Neither human nor beast. Something entirely different.
Erst!
Do not call me by that name. Listen to me, Foth. No, Summoner Foth. Do not get closer to the Nether and never touch it. We will put a stop to it by sheer power if we must.
He's acting strange.
Yes, power. Power.
Erst?
Without a show of power, they wouldn't understand. They cannot. Words pale before a demonstration of what we speak. Yes, this is perfect timing. Witness the horror of one who has been corrupted by Nether.
What the hell?
With your own body, Foth.
Oh my gosh. God! Here he comes. On guard, Foth. Why? Why did it have to turn out this way, Erst?
Damn. Erst was like his idol. And a reason probably why he became a summoner to begin with. To be corrupted and to have to face him. This is terrible. Damn it, Erst.
Foth, you have to retaliate. This is terrible. Why? Why did it have to turn out this way, Erst?
Level-wise, they shouldn't be that bad, right? I'm 15. Erst is 19. I can still beat him. Because we're, early 20s. We got this.
bug here to squash. Oh, I was hoping that would do it. Should I go in? I feel like I want to go in. Yeah. Damn, 129? I'm talking about. This guy, we can do it easy enough. Put you up here. Blast him. Is there anyone on the bottom level? Oh yeah, these two. Side back up, I guess. End it there. He can summon them? Oh. Okay, we have to go kill him then. I didn't know. Damn it. It's kind of terrible. Jeez, 64. Oh. Let us go, please. We gotta rush. Kika fruit. And I can make him do use a Kika too. Just cause why not? And as for down here, they're coming back, because if he can summon, there's no point in trying otherwise. We can move back. We just gotta get up there. We gotta start slicing at him quickly. Ow. Yes, thank you for that. Being annoying with their attacks. Ow. Stay alive. Volt is like supercharged though. He should be able to take a lot of good hits. Ow. Actually, even if I could, this wouldn't be a good kind of situation to do that. Let's just smash him with my blade. Get them up. We gotta get them up. Kika yourself.
You could actually keep it yourself too, because just use a turn. Why not? Honestly, I don't see the point in not healing her. I don't think there'd be any use in that. Damn it, she's gonna die. There's too many of them. They're doing huge damage. Maybe she's gonna die? I don't know. Come on. Ow. Ow. How's he not dead? I think that would have killed him. Guess not. He healed from that? Oh. Yeah, because that's what he's doing every round. He's healing like 70 or something, right? That's stupidly terrible. Damn it, man. I would have played this better if I knew. I'm gonna do just damage like crazy to him. Why can't she run up this? The rest of them can, and she can't? Is that, like, prone in movement? I don't understand. The big hits, man. Damn, hurts. Is he not on defense? I thought he was on defense. It doesn't seem like he gets anything. Come on, whatever. Of course he goes after her. Bastard.
Damn it.